Hello, welcome to the presentation of the EBICS API Client application. In this session, I will demonstrate how to use this application and explain how it can benefit your business. We will cover the following key features: RESTful API, Access Policy, Execute Orders, and Schedule Jobs. Finally, I'll describe potential features. Let's begin. I'm clicking Start with EBICS API button and navigating to Sign In page. On the Sign In page, there are two options to sign in, by GitHub or by OpenID. I choose to sign in by OpenID. I have signed in, and now I see the list of connections. I haven't connection yet, so I need to add a new one. But first of all, I need to generate main API key. For this, I'm going to Settings page. And on this page, I need to click Generate button in the block of main API key. I have generated API key, and now I can go back to the connections list to continue create a new connection. To create a new connection, I need to click Add Connection button and enter bank's provided credentials. Choose Generate and Store Keyring. Then select EBICS version. The latest version is 3.0. Choose Keyring is certified option. An authorized version is a 0.0.6. Finally, I'm clicking Create button. And now I can activate this connection. To activate it, I am clicking Activate button. And then I am clicking Send Initialization button and Utilize Connection to the bank. Now, I can download PDF file letter and send it to the bank. And after the bank had Activate Connection, I can to click Confirm Activation button. Nice! And now, I can finish with Activation of Connection. The first feature is RESTful API. I go to the API tab. On this page, I see the list of API methods grouped by type. The first group is Connections, that provides methods to create, update, delete, and list connections. The next group is Keyrings, that allows generate, init, confirm, suspend, generate letter, and change secret operation under Keyrings. The next group is the most largest is order types group. This is the list of allowed to be executed order types on the bank server. In general, there are four groups of order types. There are information group, download group, upload group, and sign group. The next group is access logs. By this method, I can get access logs for connections. And the last group is fetched files. By these methods, I can get a list of fetched files and download exactly the files. All the API methods are described by description, arguments with detailed explanation, response message, and usage example. The next feature is Access Policy. EBICS Bank will provide you credential to establish connection with permitted order types. EBICS API Client application lets you expand this access policies by creating multiple IP keys with customized permissions. To demonstrate this, I'm navigating to the Settings tab. Here I need to navigate to API keys for connection block. Here is the list of API keys for connections. I will create a new one. I'm clicking Add API Key button. Selecting Connection. And permissions I would like to be allowed by this key. After this, I'm clicking Generate button. I have generated new API key, and now I can copy and use it for restricted connection. The next feature is Execute Orders. Executing orders is straightforward and user-friendly with EBICS API Client. To demonstrate it, I will navigate to the Storage tab. Here I am navigating to the Storage Orders block and clicking Execute Order Type button. On this form can select connection. An order type to be executed. For example, here is info order type. And here is download order type that adds additional two parameters for the interval of dates. Upload order type has additional parameters to upload the file. I can select the file to be uploaded. And finally, click Execute button. File was uploaded, and I see information that it was successful. The next feature is Scheduler Jobs. With Scheduled Jobs, you can configure regular execution of order transactions to fetch files. To demonstrate this, I am navigating to Storage tab, to Block Scheduler and clicking Scheduler Jobs button. And here I need to add a new job. I am selecting connection, then selecting order type, then selecting regularity. It could be daily or hourly. For download, operations also have interval of dates. But I will select back info operation to continue, and clicking Create button. Now schedule job created, but it has paused. Status. To start at regular execution, I need to switch job to run status. Also, and click manual run to test this job is executed. Okay, now it's run. After I clicked button manually run, I have fetched one file. I can see this file on files page. Here is this file and I can download it. To set up regular execution by crontab, I need to go to settings tab, scroll to block, scheduler job cron, and copy cron URL. Also, and click manual run to test cron URL. While I demonstrated how features work, we made requests. Those were logged and can be seen on this logs page. Potential features. The EBICS API client is designed for secure data handling and easy extensibility. Future features could include SEPA file builder and editor feature that means to create and edit files before upload to the bank's server. Webhook notifications feature that means get real-time alerts on transaction statuses. File management feature that means view, search and manage stored fetched files. Have your own ideas for enhancements? I would love to hear them. You have seen how the EBICS API client can streamline your business operations. Ready to get started? Contact me today to explore how this application can work for you. Thank you for your attention. Bye.